गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 6, दैट इज एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डेरिवेटिव। राइट बेटा, इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव डन रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ क्वांटिटीज। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डन दिस टॉपिक, रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ क्वांटिटीज एंड रिलेटेड एग्जाम्पल्स। राइट, so today we will do some more questions related to this topic, that is rate of change of quantities. Right, so first question, a particle moves along the curve, a particle moves along the curve 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. Right, so find the points on the curve at which y coordinate is changing as fast as x coordinate. Right beta, a particle moves along the curve 6y is equal to x cube plus 2 and we want to find points on this curve at which y coordinate is changing as fast as x coordinate. What it means? It means we are given dy dt is equal to a times of dx dt. We are given this condition because y coordinate is changing as fast as x coordinate. Y coordinate is changing eight times as fast as x coordinate. Right beta, so we are given the curve 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. Right, so firstly we will find, differentiate it with respect to time t both side. So 6 dy dt is equal to 3x square dx dt plus 0. Derivative of y with respect to time t is dy dt. Firstly, we will differentiate this function x cube with respect to x. So, derivative of this with respect to x becomes 3x square. Then, differentiate x with respect to t. And derivative of constant term becomes 0. Right? Now, we are given this condition. Dy dt is equal to a times of dx dt. We are given this condition. So on the place of dy dt, you use a times of dx dt is equal to 3x square dx dt. So dx dt will cancel out. 3 1 jar 3, 3 2 jar 6. Right? So on simplifying it, we got 16 is equal to x square. It means x is equal to plus minus 4. X is equal to plus minus 4. So these are the values of x. Right? Now to find the values of y, we use these values in this function. Right beta? So we got so when we use these values, x is equal to plus 4 and x is equal to minus 4, in this function 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. Right? So when we put x is equal to 4, we got 6y is equal to 4 cube plus 2. दैट मीन्स 6y इज इक्वल टू 64 प्लस 2. सो 6y इज इक्वल टू 66, दैट मीन्स y इज इक्वल टू 11. 66 डिवाइडेड बाय 6, 6 1 जा 6, 6 1 जा 6, सो y इज इक्वल टू 11. सो पॉइंट्स ऑन द कर्व इज 4, 11, राइट. Now to find another point, what we will do? We put x is equal to minus 4 in this equation. So 6y is equal to x cube plus 2. So when we put x is equal to minus 4 here, we got minus 64 plus 2. So 6y is equal to minus 62. So the value of y becomes minus 62 divided by 6. So 2 3 ja 6, 2 3 ja 6, 2 1 ja 2. So value of y becomes minus 31 upon 3. So value of y becomes minus 31 upon 3. So point on the curve is minus 4 comma minus 31 divided by 3. Right? So point on the curve is minus 4, minus 31 upon 3. Right? Any doubt up to here? Okay. Now we will do next question. The total cost CX in rupees associated with the production of X units of an item is given by CX is equal to 0.007 x cube minus 0.003 x square plus 15x plus 4000. So we are given this cost function. What we have to find? Find the marginal cost. What we have to find? Find the marginal cost when 17 units are produced. When 17 units are produced. Right, beta? So what we will do? Firstly, what is marginal cost? Firstly, what is marginal cost? It is, suppose marginal cost is denoted by MC. So it is your DC DX, change in cost function with respect to X. Right? So we will find here DC DX. So we are given C is equal to 0.07 x cube minus 0.003 x square plus 15x plus 4000. Right? Now we will differentiate it with respect to X. Now derivative of this one, 0.007. Derivative of x cube, it is what? It is 3x square, right? Now minus 0.003, derivative of x square, it is 2x, plus derivative of 15x, it is plus 15. Now derivative of 4000, it is a constant term, That's why its derivative is equal to 0. Now we will put x is equal to 17 here. We got 0.007 into 3 into x square means 17 square minus 0.03 into 2x means 2 multiplies 17 plus 50. So we got 7 threes are 21. So 0.021. Right, beta? Now 17 multiplies 17 becomes 289. Right? Minus. We got 0.03. 003 multiply 17 to the 34 plus 50. Right, beta? Now we will simplify. It is 6.069 minus 0.102 plus 50. Right, beta? So, firstly, what you will do? Firstly, we will combine the positive term. 6.069 plus 15. It is 21.069 minus 0.102. So we got 7 6 9, so 20.967, which is your required result, which is your required marginal cost, which is your required marginal cost. Right, beta? Any doubt up to here? So, in this way, you will do question related to rate of change of quantities. Right, beta?